Hello kid, well come with me, let's meet Diya today. Well, Diya is a small little kid like you and the other day her dad was telling her that all the lovely tasty fruits and vegetables that we have, where do they actually come from? They come from plants. Hearing that, Diya was super excited. She wanted to know more about it. So Diya and her parents went to the forest and there they saw some ripe mangoes, which they had it gladly. But while roaming, they didn't realize when Diya got lost and she couldn't find her parents. So after Diya got lost, she was very confused which way to go, because this is the first time she was coming in the forest. She tried to go here, there, everywhere, searching for her parents. But at the end, she started feeling hungry after running around. Now, she knew that her dad had told her the fruits and vegetables that we eat come from plants. Although Diya was surrounded by so many plants with great fruits and vegetables, she was very, very confused about what to eat. Then she felt sad because she was hungry. Seeing her sad and crying, a magical plant suddenly spoke up. Well, it asked Diya, "What happened? Why are you crying?" Diya said that she had lost her way and couldn't find her parents, and now she was hungry. So the beautiful magical plant told, "You can eat my fruits. They are very tasty and I'm sure these fruits will help you to satisfy your hunger." So Diya happily ate the fruits of the plant. Then she went to sleep. When she woke up the next day, she was again feeling hungry, but there were no fruits on the plant. So, do you know what the magical plant said? The plant was so sweet, it said that you can have my sweet flowers. They are also very sweet and these will satisfy your hunger. So, the next day, Diya had the flowers on the plant. In the same way, even on the third day, Diya was hungry. So, you can see there was no fruits, no flowers. So what could the plant give her? Well, it gave her its leaves. So Diya fed on the leaves. Days passed by and after the plant lost its fruits, flowers and leaves, finally it was the turn of the stem. Even the plant was so sweet that it gave her stem to Diya so that she could eat it and remain alive. Finally, when the plant had nothing with it, it sacrificed its life by giving the last part, that is the roots, to Diya. So Diya ate that and then she slept. The next day when Diya's father found her, she was sleeping. She was okay, she was alive and she was not hungry. So here we see how a beautiful magical plant sacrificed its life for Diya. Yes, it's correct. Every day we eat lots of delicious fruits, vegetables, which all come from the plants. So along with these delicious fruits, we also get oil, seeds like the rice and tea and coffee, which we love to have it. So plants give us everything. So there are many parts of plants which are edible. That is, we eat different kinds of parts of plants. See, we eat fruits, vegetables, root, flower, stem, leaves. So here you can see many parts of plants are edible, and fruits, vegetables, root, flower, stem and leaves are the edible parts of plants. See, first we see the different kind of fruits that we have, like the mango, grapes, watermelon, apples. We all love to have these, right? But all of these different fruits come from plants. Not only fruits, we also eat vegetables in our daily lives, right? Like the potato, cauliflower, brinjal and cabbage. So all these different vegetables also come from plants. Now, other than fruits and vegetables, we also eat root, stem, leaves. So what are those plants of which we eat root, stem and leaves? Let's see. First, coming to roots, we have our very favorite carrot, radish and turnip. So all of these three are vegetables which we eat, and they are the roots of different plants. Now if you see the stems, we see the potato and ginger. These are the stems of the plants which we feed on. The next edible part is the leaves. I'm sure you love to have green leafy vegetables like spinach and lettuce. Also, flowers are beautiful, which we love to keep in our homes. But some flowers are edible as well, just like the squash blossom and cauliflower. So these are the flowers of the plants. Even we eat the bud of a flower. See, this is a banana flower bud. We cook it and have it. So we use buds to eat. After all the other parts, now we have got the seeds. The very common rice that we have and wheat. These are the seeds of the plants. So I have a question for you. Rice is obtained from, is it option 1, animals, or option 2, rocks, or option 3, plants? Well, let me tell you, the first option is animals. Rice is obtained from seeds, which are definitely not from animals. So, animal is a wrong option. Now, coming to number 2 is rocks. If you see, rocks are non-living things. So, it does not have any part like seed. So, rocks are also wrong option. The correct option is plants. Rice is the seed of a plant. So, we saw over here that there are different edible parts of the plants, like the fruits, roots, seeds and leaves. So, these are the different edible parts which are delicious and nutritious as well.